Hey guys, so I'm Becky and today you are going to be learning how to complete a crystal toe pedicure. So I hope you're all super excited. This is a nice, quick and easy treatment. It shouldn't take you much longer than 30 minutes to complete once you've done a couple of them, and you can make an awesome profit from it as well. So in Ireland, the recommended price to charge for crystal toes is €45. In the US, as far as I know, that is quite substantially higher. Your cost price in Ireland is less than €10, including genuine Swarovski crystals to keep that sparkle. So let's go, and I hope you enjoy. Okay, so ideally you want to be using Swarovski crystals when you are doing crystal toe pedicures because they will hold their sparkle better than any other crystal that you can get on the market. And that's what clients are going to want if they are booking in for this treatment. It's going to last them a couple of weeks, so you want the products to last as long as the treatment does. So you are going to need your cuticle pushy and your nippers. You're going to need a file, preferably one that has been used so it's not too rough. You're going to need a bonder and a base gel. You're going to need your clear gel. All the products that we're going to be using are Flirty's products. You're going to need your 2-in-1 cleanser. You're going to need your gel brush. And this little tool here is great for picking up diamonds. You literally just poke the diamond with it and it picks up. You'll need some lint-free wipes. And that is all. Okay, so here we have our lovely foot model. So I'm going to start by just prepping her nail. So I'm working my cuticle chisel around her sidewalls at the moment to remove any loose bits of cuticle. We are lifting and loosening, we're not gouging. So we're working all the way around the sides. Then we're going to work along her cuticle line at the back to remove any dead cuticle. So I'm making sure that I'm doing a really good job getting right into the sidewalls and around the back of the nail. There's nothing worse when you get your toes done and then you have a little look at them afterwards and whoever did them didn't actually go right the way down to your sidewalls, so you can see a lovely big gap all the way around. So you want to make sure that you get right into your sidewalls so you can paint them or get your gel right the way down. So I'm just nipping off any little loose bits. There's normally a few little loose bits when you are doing a pedicure. You want to make sure you don't cut the epinicium, that you're literally just lifting away any dead bits of cuticle. Okay, so we're going to move on to the other toes then. You know yourself, sometimes little toes don't go as nicely or as easily as the big toe. Sometimes they're a bit bumpy, a bit ridgy, shaped differently to other toes, a little bit thick, a little bit thin. So just do the best that you can on them, get them as neat as possible, work your way through all of them, and then we can move on. Okay, so I am going to speed this up loads right now, just so that you can see me working through all of these toes, but that you're also not sitting here for 20 minutes watching me do prep on 10 toes, because once you can do prep perfectly on one toe, you can do prep perfectly on all of them. So I'm just giving them a little wipe with the brush, as you can see in the video as well, as we go, to make sure I've gotten all the loose bits off. So I'm just working my way around this toenail, which isn't shaped quite as nicely as the other ones. He's a little bit more round, so he'll be a little bit more difficult to work with. And then the baby toenails that we have to work with here are really tiny. Okay, so on to matching up the other foot. Working around the big toenail again. You guys should be able to see the prep work a little bit better on the big toenail. Clipping and wiping, clipping and wiping. Making sure the toe is totally clear. You want to make sure that you do as good a job on every single toenail. Third last toenail. Now again, this toenail isn't quite as perfect. It's not as bad as the one on the other foot, but this one isn't great. And then we have a teeny tiny little baby toenail then as well to work with. Okay, so once you have done all of your cuticle work, we are going to move on to filing the toes. So I'm going to take any very sharp edges away from the corners, and I am going to file the toenail pretty much straight across, but just with a very, very slightly rounded edge, just to make sure that there's no sharp bits. So I am using my file that has been used a good bit before on fingernails, just to make sure I don't cut my client's toe while I'm filing. With our files that we use for toes, they are old files that we've used for fingers, but they only get used on one person's toes and then they go in the bin. So again, same with this toe, slightly rounded shape, and I've just made sure I've taken any rough edges off the two corners. And I'm going to work my way across all of the toes in the same fashion. So I'm just speeding this foot up a little bit while I'm shaping up the rest of the toes. Pinky toes are a little bit more difficult to file, so I'm just adjusting the foot slightly, tilting it a little bit to the side so that I can get right in with my file and get the best shape that I can on them. Okay, now it is time to really lightly buff over the top of the nail to create a scratched surface, which is going to be our mechanical bond for our gel application. So you want to be really careful that you don't buff the skin when you're doing this, and you're just taking the shine away from the top of the nail. We're not buffing really deep down into the nail or gouging the nail in any way. We are literally just taking the top shine off. While you're doing this bit, you'll also see if there's any other little loose bits of cuticle or nail or anything that need to be filed, so you can get them at this stage as well. And again, I'm using my used file so that there isn't as much grit left on it, so that it doesn't damage the nail while I'm filing. You want to make sure that you get all around your cuticle line and right down your sidewalls. Take your time when you're doing this step. It is important to make sure you've got a really good mechanical bond. The better your mechanical bond, the better your nails are going to last. And just the big toe now. Just tilting the foot slightly back to where it was so that I can get right into my sidewalls and my cuticle line as easily as possible. Remember guys, you need to be as comfortable as possible when you're working. You've got to bend over like this 8 to 10 hours a day. Our clients just have to sit like that for half an hour. So even if it's not the most comfortable for them, having to tilt their foot back and forward, you need to take care of your own back first. Once you're happy, you can move on. So I'm giving them a little dust over to make sure I can see that I've buffed everywhere on the nail. And now I'm taking my 2-in-1 cleanser on a lint-free wipe, and I am scrubbing the nails as much as I can. So right around the sidewalls, across your cuticle line, and across your free edge. You want to make sure you really scrub those nails. Get them as dehydrated and as cleansed as possible. You might need to use your nail a little bit on pinky toes if the nail is hiding a little bit. Okay, so you're going to match up the other foot, make sure it's all nice and buffed and cleansed, and then roll up a little piece of tissue or use a toe rope to separate out the toes nicely there. You're going to take your bonder and apply your bonder onto each toe in turn. If you're using a bonder that needs to be cured, make sure you cure it for the appropriate time. Oh, look, lovely hair. Let's get him off. Flirty's bonder doesn't need to be cured. It air dries. So we're just going to paint that over all of the nails. Keep it on the nail. Avoid the skin area. This is just going to help everything to stick to the nail. Okay, so next up is our base gel. And you're going to pop a little blob of base gel into the center of each of the nails. Just a small amount if you're using the Flirty's base. If you're using your own base, you'll know how much to use. And you want to take your gel brush and really work that product into the nail. So this is where your mechanical bond really comes into it. You are pushing that gel right down and removing any little bits of fluff. You're pushing that right gel right down into the little scratches that you made when you were taking the shine off the top of the nail. This might seem like a small step, but it's really where the bond really comes from. So whether you're doing toes, fingers, no matter what type of gels you're doing, this is a really, really important step. You want to really work that base gel into the nail. So I'm just speeding this up a little bit, just on the last three nails there. So make sure, see the way I'm sealing in the free edge there as well? You want to make sure you do that too on each of them. And get right into the pinky as close as you can. So once you've got that done, it's time to pop them underneath the lamp for the required time for your gel. So with the Flirty's gel, your base gel goes under for 60 seconds. Okay, so once that's finished, I'm just going to get my diamonds ready. So I have a little empty tub here and I'm just pouring them from the bag into the empty tub, just a few at a time so it's easy for me to pick them out without them spilling all over the place. And I'm just going to leave the diamonds beside me. I've got my tub of clear gel ready and I'm going to pick up a small amount of product. So you can see I've got a little bead there. I'm going to pick up a little bit more than that. You can see my little bead. I'm doing a big toe, so I need a decent amount of product. Then I'm going to pop it right into the middle of the nail. And then I'm going to start to work it towards the cuticle line and down my side walls. I want to spread it nice and evenly over the nail. I don't want it so thick that it runs into the side walls, but I do want it thick enough that I can push the diamonds down into it, so they stay in place. So you can see I'm just circular motions, wiggling that around the whole nail. All the way around. So I've covered the whole nail now in a layer of gel and I'm sealing in my free edge. And I'm just going to put the gel out of the way for a couple of seconds so I don't knock it over. So I've got my little tool that I'm going to use for picking up my diamonds. And rest them just there, pick up the first one and press it down into the gel. Go ahead with the second one, press it down. Now because it's gel, you can wiggle these around until you're happy with the placement. So pop them down, give them a wiggle, make sure the gel kind of wraps around the base of the diamond or the crystal. And ideally always start at your cuticle line and work towards the tip of the nail. Because if you start at the tip of the nail and work backwards, what might happen is you may end up with a gap. If you start at the base and you work forward and you end up with a little gap, you can always shorten the nail slightly to kind of fix the gap, if that makes sense. So always start at your cuticle line. Then you're going to try and stagger the diamonds or the crystals in each row so that they sit really nicely together. The crystals that we're using today are SS9s. If you wanted them to be even sparklier and with smaller crystals, you could use SS7s or SS5s. And that's the kind of size of the crystal. So these ones are chunky enough, but they look fantastic on toes. The one thing I will say about the likes of the SS7s and the SS5s, you can get them into little small creases a little bit easier, and they tend to all fit together a little bit nicer so that you get way more of them on, but then your cost of the treatment is going to increase slightly. So for this full set, I used approximately 120 crystals. There's 200 in the packs of crystals that we buy. So if you were to use SS7s, you would probably use the full 200 crystals, which is totally fine because I always budget for a full pack. So the cost price of 10 euro that we've kind of, or well, of less than 10 euro, we have budgeted for an entire pack to be used in one set of nails. So I'm picking up the crystals that are the right way around. I'm literally just tapping my tool on them, picking them up and popping them onto the nail. Pick up, place. So you can see these are going on nice and quickly, nice and easily. And once if I see a little gap or that, I'm just kind of pressing them there, wiggling them around, making sure they fit really nicely. And I'm giving them a good press down into the gel to make sure that they're nice and stable. And place. So you can see there's loads of crystals going on here, and they're already starting to look absolutely amazing. Now you will have clients as well who may want their large toe full of crystals and the rest of their toes just painted, so you can do that as an option for them. If you were to do a full set of nails and your client wanted a full crystal fingernail, this is exactly the same way that you would do it. So pick up, place, work your way all the way to the tip of the nail. These are looking absolutely gorgeous. How sparkly are they already? So I'm just pressing around the sides now, making sure the side ones are nice and flat. Making sure I'm happy with how they're sitting. That we're nice and right up to the tip of the toe and down to the cuticle and around to right up to the sides of the sidewalls. How sparkly is that toe? That looks amazing. I hope you're getting excited now to start doing this on clients. This is an amazing treatment. Your clients will absolutely love it. So I'm just perfecting where I want those crystals to go. Ooh, look at that toe. And what I'm going to do now really quickly is I am just going to cure that for a few seconds so that when I move on to the next toe and I start working on the next toe, if I happen to lean against the first one or I drop something on the first one or anything, it won't move my crystals. So I'm just giving it a little bit of a cure, and I will cure it completely at the very end with all of the rest of the toes. Perfect, that'll do me for now. I'm just double checking that they are all set. They are, nothing's budging on me. Perfect. Now, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to do two toes and then I'll do two toes again. So I'm picking up a little bead of gel, placing it on the toe, across my free edge. Making sure I have enough. All the way across my free edge. And I'm going to pop my little bead of gel on my next toe as well. So these ones are much smaller, so I can kind of work on two at a time rather than just one by one. Okay, so I'm just spreading my gel around the third toe, making sure it's thick enough that my diamonds will stay on nicely, and sealing in my free edge and getting off that little bit of gel that I got on the skin. You don't want to cure any gels for the skin ever. Okay. So I've got my crystals back in place, got my little jewel, and I'm going to start again, picking them up and placing them on. Obviously, these toes get done a heck of a lot quicker than the big toe because they are so much smaller. So depending on the size of your client's toe will depend on how quickly you get the set done and how many diamonds you use throughout your set. So I am ideally squeezing as many crystals on as possible. You don't want to be skimpy with the crystals. This is the kind of treatment that your clients will get done once and they will absolutely adore it. So make sure you give them a super high quality service the first time to make sure that they want to keep coming back to you every time for the service. And we're almost finished the second toe here now. And he is looking fabulous. I'm just squeezing one last one in there. Spreading the others out a little bit. Look how sparkly they are. They look amazing. And I'm going to do the next one then really quick before I do any curing. I'm not going to fit as many diamonds on this toenail because they are getting smaller as we go down. Gorgeous. Okay, so everything out of the way so I can pick the lamp up and cure them for a few seconds in my lamp. Again, this isn't to fully cure them, this is just to hold them in place so that when I'm doing the last two, if I knock off them, I won't wreck them in any way. Okay, that'll do. Okay, so the last two toes, I'm getting my client just to twist very slightly to make sure that I can really see what I'm doing here. And I'm popping a little bit of gel onto the first one of the two. A little bit then onto our teeny tiny little toe, just as much as I can on this guy. I'm not going to get very many crystals on, I'd say maybe three or four if I'm lucky. Crystals back out, my last two toes. Make sure you give them a good press down, make sure they're nice and secure. Again, how many of these you get on will totally depend on the size of your client's toe. giving them a good press down, squeezing on as many as I can, and then onto the last little toe. So getting my last few little crystals on this foot. They're so sparkly, so pretty, absolutely love them. Hope you guys are so excited for these. Your clients are going to love you forever. Last few going on. Look how much they sparkle. Okay, and I'm going to stick them in the lamp for the full 60 seconds to cure them. If your gel takes longer than 60 seconds to cure, then leave them in for the full required curing time. Okay, now let's take the lamp away and look at our sparkly toes. Now just give them a nice good little rub. You can be rough with them, make sure they're nice and stuck and nothing's loose. Pop off your little toe rope or your little bit of tissue. And voila! Look how much they sparkle. You are done. If your gel leaves behind a little sticky residue, you can give them a little wipe with a lint-free pad and your cleanser. And then you can swap feet. Get the other foot up and ready to go. So I'm popping my toe rope or my tissue back into these toes. I'm getting my cleanser on a lint-free wipe and I am literally going to repeat the entire process again on my second foot. So we've already prepped the toes. I've just cleansed again and now we are applying our bonder to all of the toes. So I'm then going to apply a little bead of base gel onto the middle of each of the nails. And then using my gel brush, I'm going to really work that into the nail. Again, this is creating our bond for the nail, so I want to make sure I do a really good job of working this in. So once I have that really nicely worked into the nail, we are going to pop our lamp over the toes for 60 seconds. Okay, so I'm going to speed this up again so that you can watch the technique again, but so that you can see it in slightly quicker motion this time. So I am working on the big toe, spreading my gel, my little blob of gel, all the way around the big toe. And once I've got the gel on, I am going to start popping my little crystals on again. So again, I have this sped up a little bit, so if you want to watch it in slightly quicker motion, you can watch it here, or if you want to watch it in standard motion, you can watch the earlier part of the video again. So you can see we do fly through popping these on. They're nice and easy once you've done a couple of sets. You can see them filling up nicely there now. And we're almost halfway on this big toe. Don't forget, we do also have the Facebook support group for everybody who has done their training with us. So you can jump on there, share your pictures, and see pictures of other people's work as well, get ideas, get some inspiration. We almost have this big toe done. correctly. Look how amazing that is. And we're going to pop him in the lamp, give him a quick little cure just to hold the crystals in place. So if I bang off them, we won't cause any harm. Now I'm going to go ahead and pop my gel on the next two toes, get them ready for my crystal application. Now, let's get our next lot of crystals on. So we're working on the second toe, filling it up as much as possible, getting as many crystals on there as we can. Remember, no skimping on the crystals, you want them to be nice and full. Nice and shiny. The smaller the crystal you choose, the more crystals you're going to have to use. Huh. I'm a poet and I didn't know it. And cure. Now remember, you're just curing it for a couple of seconds just to hold them in place. We'll give it a full cure at the very end. So I'm going to get my gel on the last two toes, get them ready for their crystals. We're almost done now. Crystals on two more toes and then that's it. All done. Now, so let's get the crystals then on the last two toes. This toe is slightly arched, so it's a little bit more difficult to place the crystals, so you may need to use a little bit more gel to make sure that it really holds the crystals in place. And then we'll do this last little toe. Now let's have a little wiggle just to see how shiny they are. Look how sparkly they are. They're amazing. And let's give them their full cure for 60 seconds or whatever your gel takes to cure. Take the lamp away and voila! We are sparkly. Let's get rid of that toe rope and let's have a little wiggle of those toes. Look how pretty they are and sparkly. Let's get the other toe up here as well. Whoop. Now, look how nice they are. A little sparkle, a little bit of oil, nourish the cuticles, and a little toe wiggle. So pretty. I hope you guys like them. I hope you're excited to get going with them. They'll be no bother to any of you, and if anyone has any questions at all, give me a shout, and I am more than happy to help. Thank you for watching, and good luck!